Hi there, and welcome back to the channel. If you've had any experience thus far in Squarespace with adding hyperlinks either to images or just within text, you may have found that it's quite a multi-step process. Not difficult, but just a few extra steps than you really need, and if you don't remember to hit that apply, all your work just goes out the window when you close the little link box. So if you don't know what I'm talking about, that's okay. In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you both the current way or the old way, depending on when you're watching this video, of adding and editing links in Squarespace. But I'm also going to be sharing with you an exciting new feature as well. But if we haven't met yet, my name is Meg. I'm a former yoga and meditation teacher turned Squarespace web designer, and I'm here to help you elevate your business without the tech overwhelm. So let's talk about some links. There's an exciting new feature in the links world in Squarespace where they have updated the interface for adding, editing, and dealing with links in your Squarespace website, and it's a huge improvement over where we were, so we're going to cover that today. Now, depending again on when you're watching this video, you may still be working with the old version, or you may have just started with a new version and aren't quite sure where to begin. So in this video, it's quick, it's short. I'm going to cover both, so wherever you are, you can watch, but if you are jumping in here and you already have the new version or just might, seen the new version pop up in your site, you can jump ahead in the video and you can go straight to that section there. But we'll start with kind of the classic links editor, and then we'll move in with the new links editor, which I think you're really going to like. I know it's been a huge improvement for me. I have been a classic person of forgetting to hit apply once I've put in links and closing out the box and having them all disappear. Ugh. Nothing worse than having to redo work you've already done. So this new version makes this so much easier. So let's jump on over into my demo site and I'll show you how it works. So first we'll go with the standard. So if I'm here in a text box and I want to add a link, I want to highlight the text, and then I can just click link. It's very similar to any word processor. And then in here, if you can type directly in here, if I want to select a page from the website, I can hit backslash, then it'll give me the opportunity to choose one of those pages. So for example, I could click about, and then I could just hit apply and we're done. But what if you want this to go to a external link, like an article or another website? If you know the address, you can type it right in here, or just to show you all of your options, pages here, same as I was showing you before. You can have it linked to a file if you want somebody to download a file, phone number, but also just say if you wanted a web address, you could type that in here. And we'll just have it go to my website for now. And you have the option to open in a new window or not. So best practice for SEO. If you are linking to an external website, you want to open it in a new window. This will open a new tab in your browser and it will keep your website open. And then it will open a separate tab for this new link. That keeps the traffic that's on your website, and it doesn't hurt you from an SEO perspective. If you were to close this off, then that traffic is going to move off your website, and in its place, that new page is going to open up and the traffic is going to go there. So best practice SEO, external websites, have them open in a new window. If you're just going to another page within your website, you can have this checked off. All right, but let's hit save. Very important point here. You're not done. You have to then hit apply for the link to take, and you'll see the underline go here. So that's how that works. If you want to edit it, again, you would highlight it and then you would click on the link. It'll show this thing is up here. You can edit it. Again, you'd have to hit reapply. But if you just want to remove it, you can click remove and you're all set. So now I'll show you the new way this interface will look. Okay, so in the new link editor style, process is pretty much the same, but it's a little bit easier. It's has fewer clicks involved to deal with. So let's go back into our text and we'll highlight this text again. And I'm going to click link again. But hey, now you'll notice a little bit difference here. You don't have that cogwheel. You don't have that remove or apply. So you can, from here, from a dropdown, choose whether it's going to be an external URL, a file, an email, or a phone. But what about pages, Megan? Where did internal pages go? Hopefully that will be showing up in here as well soon, but you can still hit that backslash and it'll bring up your pages. So if I wanted to go to a contact page, and you can then click if you wanted that to open in a new tab. And you can also just delete this out here. If you want it to be a URL, you can type in the URL, whatever you want to do here. I also want to point out, go back into that, that the default, when you set this up, has it defaulting to opening in a new tab, which is nice because most of the time you're probably going to be linking to an external website. So it's one less click to have to remember to have that open in a new tab. But for example, I'm just going to type in a page here. I want it to go to about page. This is all good. You'll notice there's no apply here. So I can just hit enter and the link is there. So a little bit more simplified interface, a lot easier to manage. And then same goes for here if I want to change it. So this is great. Please ignore this. This is Grammarly. It has nothing to do with Squarespace. But it shows what page it's linked to. Gives you, you hover, it shows the full URL. So I can edit that link. I can copy that link. That's super freaking helpful now. Or I can just remove the link. So it's a much more streamlined interface. It's a lot easier to manage and get more information. And I love that you can copy, if you're doing like affiliate links or things like that, or you're linking to blog posts, that makes your life a lot easier. Now, if you're doing links in image blocks, for example, so if I quickly kind of just throw out an image block here for you, and I'm just going to hit here, I'm not going to add it, but you might see this attach link. So before you had kind of just a line with that kind of settings wheel and you could choose, move this over a little bit, you could choose the link in the old fashioned way. Now you would click attach link and it opens up that same window that I showed you before. So depending again, where you are in this rollout, you may see this new style or you may see the old style. So they both work great, but don't panic if you see something different. That's why I wanted to go over them both here so you know how to use them both depending on which version you currently have on your website. So what do you think? Think that's going to make your life easier if you've been a Squarespace user for a while? I'd love to hear your thoughts. Drop me a comment down below. Let me know what you think of this new editor experience in Squarespace for links. And if there's anything else that you're interested in learning about Squarespace in the editor or website design or just how to integrate things with Squarespace and your business, feel free to drop me a comment down below. I'd love to hear from you, and maybe I'll make a video about the topic you're interested in the near future. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you again soon.